Dear students, let us discuss a problem on damped vibration. The damped vibration records of a spring mass damper system show the following data. Amplitude of the second cycle is 12 mm. Okay, so this is x2. Amplitude on the third cycle is 10.5 mm. So this is x3. Stiffness of the spring S is given as 7840 newton per meter. Mass of the block M is given as 2 kilogram. It is asked to determine the damping coefficient of the vibratory system. Okay, we can note down the significant data given in the problem. The first data is the amplitude of the second cycle X2 is 12 millimeter, and amplitude of the third cycle is given as 10.5 millimeter. Stiffness of the spring S is given as 7840 newton per meter. Mass of the block M is given as 2 kilogram. It is asked to find the damping coefficient of the damper used in the system. So we can use the relationship between the damping ratio zeta and damping coefficient C to calculate the damping coefficient C. Damping ratio zeta is equal to the ratio between damping coefficient and critical damping coefficient. To calculate the C, we need to calculate damping ratio and critical damping coefficient. There is a term in damped vibration analysis known to be logarithmic decrement, del, which is the natural logarithm of the ratio between two successive amplitudes, that is ln of xn by xn plus 1. Okay, which is also equal to 2 pi zeta divided by root of 1 minus zeta square. Here zeta is the damping ratio. Okay, so using these relationships we can calculate the value of damping ratio. Here in the problem, the amplitude of the second cycle and the amplitude of the third cycles are given. So we can use this logarithmic decrement formula with the given data. Ln x2 by x3 is 12 by 10.5, so the del value can be obtained as 0.1335. Now we can use this relationship formula for the logarithmic decrement. Logarithmic decrement value has been calculated in the previous step from the data available for the amplitudes of second and third cycles, 0.1335. So from which we can calculate the value of zeta. So here 2 pi zeta is equal to 0.1335 into root of 1 minus zeta square. We can square the terms in both the sides. So in the left hand side, 4 pi square zeta square is equal to 0.1335 square into 1 minus zeta square. This is 0.0178 into 1 minus zeta square. This is 0.0178 minus 0.0178 zeta square. By rearranging these terms, 4 pi square zeta square plus 0.0178 zeta square is equal to 0.0178. 39.4962 zeta square is equal to 0.0178. From which we can calculate the value of zeta square as 4.5068 into 10 power minus 4. Therefore, the damping ratio zeta will be obtained as 0.0212. In this relationship equation, we have calculated the value of damping ratio. Now we can calculate the value of CC, that is critical damping coefficient. The formula is 2m into omega n. Omega n is the circular frequency, which can be calculated as root of S by M. Mass of the block is given as 2 kg. Stiffness is given as 7840 newton per meter divided by mass is 2 kg. So the critical damping coefficient CC value can be obtained as 250.4396 newton per meter per second. In this relationship equation, we have calculated the damping ratio zeta and the critical damping coefficient CC. So by substituting those two values here, we can get the value of C, that is damping coefficient. The calculated value of zeta is 0.0212 is equal to the calculated value of CC is 250.4396. So the damping coefficient of the given vibratory system C is 5.3093 न्यूटन पर मीटर पर सेकेंड.